founder of the Dam.
Yeah, no duh.
And it's located in Fabulous,
Thorndon.
A family-owned Scottish gastropub run by his daughter, Stephanie, who's also with us today. With over 800 whiskeys, set in a quaint 1870s house that the mayor once lived in the early 1900s. Reservations are highly recommended for dinner. And level flying isn't Gord's thing, as you can see. He read hundreds of books on building planes, found mentors, took welding and metalworking courses, and in 1974 built himself a high-performance biplane. Had to extend his garage 10 feet to get it done. It took 2 years to complete and won the Keith Hopkins Award for the best home built in Canada. At the same time, he was learning aerobatics, won his first advanced contest, and barnstormed his way to first place in 7 Canadian national and open aerobatic competitions.
Well, look at this guy.
And as you watch that airplane clip over the end and hang upside down for a while before it recovers, I want you to consider one other cool thing about Gord. He's 77 years of age!
Oh, wow. How was your grandma?
Continuing to fly, of course, and have a little bit of fun when it comes to the Dam Pub, which Stephanie runs so that he can get out and play on the weekends, ladies and gentlemen. With over 900, let me correct that number now, over 900 whiskeys up in beautiful Thornbury.
Ski whiskey on the shelf. You were so quiet there by yourself.
Look at this guy.
They find you, they took you down and opened you up and passed you around. I was the first one to pull you down. You took one drink and you started to clown. Passed you the Hazel, Jane and Jack. Penelope got you and passed you right back. The doorbell rang and what did you see? In walked Henry, Fred and Marie. They hit you high, they hit you low. They hit you fast and they hit you slow. Whiskey on the shelf. You were so quiet there by yourself. Things were fine till they took you down. Opened you up and passed you down.
Continued to fly the wing and modify canopy fuselage and wheels with a pit special, and eventually started to produce his own line of aircraft kits called the 10-Dash Series. He'd add a new wing to your pits if you'd like, and in 1981 established a factory in Guelph, Ontario, and founded Ultimate Aerobatics Limited. He redesigned the concept, morphed through several phases into what's known as the Ultimate 10-300S Super Biplane, a one-of-a-kind aircraft built to look good, fly great, and win aerobatic competitions. And one that still members of our aerobatic community in the airshow industry continue to fly.
You were so quiet there by yourself. Things were fine till they took you down, opened you up and passed.